Have you ever heard of anti-design? Now, you might not know the name and you might have never heard of it, but I'm willing to bet that you've seen examples of anti-design without even knowing it. And today we're going to look at a sector of graphic design that is growing at a rapid rate and explore why it exists, what it is, and ask the question, is it about to take over the graphic design space? And later in today's video, learn how you can get a 1 month free trial to the amazing learning community Skillshare. With thousands of classes, you can start your creative journey today. So what the heck is anti-design and why should you even care? Well, anti-design is a style of design where most rules are chucked out of the window right away. The designer will purposely do things such as use hideous color palettes that clash, totally ignore alignment, choose fonts that suggest he or she doesn't know what they're doing, and often typography won't even be legible. Anti-design is shocking. It comes into the graphic design world with a sense of energy and rebellion. It's almost like the new guard is replacing the old guard. But there's a catch. It isn't maybe exactly what most people think it is. Yes, anti-design disregards many rules in graphic design and it really is quite striking. However, it still requires talent and an eye for design to get right. Take a look at these two examples of anti-design. Which one would you say is the more successful design? Now, it's obvious to most that one of these designs was created by someone who has some talent when it comes to designing, and the other one looks like a 5-year-old just jumped on MS Paint and found some clip art to put on a design. Even though rules have been broken on both, one design still looks a whole lot more decent than the other one, and of course, the green design is the one that falls short here. But why does anti-design exist exactly? Why is it even a thing? There really is just one single reason for something like anti-design to exist, but I personally have three factors in mind that I think have contributed to existing. And don't get me wrong here, yes, I love graphic design rules and they are very useful in many situations. Anti-design is a style that I would totally choose to use, but in the right situation. Every brief and every client calls for a specific approach. You cannot just slap anti-design into every project and hope it ends up looking okay in the end. Earning money as a graphic designer doesn't work like that. Anyway, the first thing I feel has contributed to anti-design is the availability of design software. Several decades ago, it used to be that a select few people would have access to graphic design tools and were able to actually create artwork. These days, you can pick up high-end software from, say, Adobe for next to nothing, or even just use 100% free software that does an excellent job too. Now, this means that anybody can make graphic designs, even that 5-year-old kid in his or her bedroom. Many people are creating design work without ever studying graphic design or learning about the principles that work so well. Again, I'm not on one side here. I feel there is a time and a place for most things in graphic design. But secondly, the designers who are bored with the rules and who have rebelled against the industry, they've kind of gained traction and notoriety. And that's because the work is so novel, so striking, and so powerful. It does make a really hard-hitting presence, and with the internet these days, such ideas are able to be shared globally in an instant. The younger generations find such a rebellion and energy intriguing for the most part. It kind of resonates with them at a deeper level. But lastly, I feel that because of what's happened globally starting back in early 2020, many people are discouraged and angry at the world. Let's face it, things are vastly different now in comparison to how they were, you know, a couple of years ago. Some people will have felt a slight change in society, whereas other people probably have lost somebody close to them or have even seen a huge change in their country they reside in. Looking back through the years, art has almost always been a reflection of society. The futurist artist in the early 20th century created work around speed, energy, and movement, and this was a reflection of the machine industry being introduced into the modern world. And then you have the Dada art movement, which was based around World War I and the rejection of a capitalist society. This sort of thing has happened over and over again throughout history, and I think that anti-design is something somewhat similar, and it's a way for people in the graphic design world to revolt against something, whatever that might be for each individual. Now, there are a lot of anti-design examples that I find interesting and actually like, but don't be fooled that any old person can just make it look good. It still requires an eye for design, in my opinion. And also remember, if you want to earn money in this industry, then you need to realize there's a time and a place for everything. So yeah, the competition that a lot of you already know about, and if you don't, then I'm going to offer 3 cash prizes from $200 to $50, and then third price, $20. And I'm thinking about doing this competition once a month on this channel, so do stay tuned to my content. Now, this competition is where I want you guys to design a Satori Graphics banner artwork for my YouTube and also maybe my Twitter, but they can be interchangeable. So just one design that can cover, you know, all social media. There are a lot of strict rules in this competition because it is a cash prize competition. So I'm trying to make sure everything is fair and, you know, above board on this competition. I'm going to require that you guys post 3 screenshots of your designs as you work through them. So kind of like a process to prove that you are actually designing it and you haven't copied it from somewhere else. And I also want you to explain your designs in at least 100 words so that I can review, you know, your thought process and the design as a whole. Details on how to enter the competition are linked in a document in the description box below. And please do read it carefully because this is a very kind of serious competition brief to follow. YouTube is not affiliated with this competition in any single way, shape, or form, and you have 7 days to hand in your designs. And again, all of the details are linked down below. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing your designs, what you come up with. Good luck, everybody, and have fun being creative. And thanks to the sponsor of today's video, Skillshare. Now, Skillshare is filled to the brim with creative classes on things like graphic design, illustration, music production, and so much more. Now, I know a lot of you out there like the motion graphics on my videos, and if you want to pick up those kind of skills to make those motion graphics, Skillshare is a great choice to do that. And I myself have been taking a class by Jake Bartlett on animating hand lettering, and that's just so I can boost my motion graphic skills as well. Skillshare is entirely curated learning, and considering there are no ads on Skillshare, you can have a laser beam focus on your learning experience. And also, Skillshare offers subtitles in their entire catalog of classes, so if English isn't your first language, they've got you covered. Now, the first 1,000 people to click the link in the description box below can get a free 1 month trial to Skillshare so you can start your creative journey today. So yeah, let me know in the comment section below what you think about anti-design, and have you seen it somewhere? Maybe in a magazine or on a TV advert or something like that. If you want to watch more graphic design content, do click a video on screen. And until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.